I'm Renee Ritchie, your YouTube creator liaison. And fun fact, I'm based in Montreal, Canada. So Bill C11 is something I've been paying extremely close attention to. It's something a lot of creators around the world have been and should keep paying attention to because it could set a global precedent, meaning it could come to wherever you are next. But more on that in a minute. Now, if you're not yet familiar with Bill C11 or the Online Streaming Act, it's aimed at modernizing Canada's Broadcasting Act to support the creation, promotion, and discoverability of Canadian creative content, or CanCon, in the digital age. And if you're not familiar with CanCon, that's a requirement for TV and radio in Canada to play just a metric ton of Degrassi Junior High and Nickelback. Literally, what's used to determine if mine, yours, or anybody's content qualifies as being Canadian enough. The bill is meant to support Canadian culture, which is fantastic, but it also gives the Canadian Radio, Television, and Telecommunications Commission, the CRTC, which is a government regulator, the power to require platforms to make financial contributions to produce CanCon, but also the power to decide how content is presented to Canadian viewers on platforms like YouTube. In other words, what gets preferential treatment? So now YouTube went to the Senate to share our concerns, mainly that the legislation as written would harm how Canadian creators reach a global audience and build our channels. And I'll link to Brandon Gonez and Todd Beaupre, who's YouTube's director of product, who just broke it all down and explained the consequences of all that in the description below. This month, the Senate took a super close look at the bill and unpacked every section in what's called a clause-by-clause review. So what if anything has changed? Well, the Senate gave better guidance to the CRTC to focus on commercial music content, and that better reflects what the government said it was actually trying to do. But what they haven't done is change the level of discretion that the CRTC has. In other words, it means the CRTC can still choose to regulate user-generated content, like our videos, if they want to. And that means that we, as creators, just don't have certainty about what decisions may get made next year, or the years after. What is clear is that creator voices mattered in this debate. They made a difference, and it's legit terrific to see that the Senate committee has made an attempt to address our concerns, the concerns of Canada's digital creators, and just a huge, enormous thank you for adding your voice to that conversation, whether it was by writing your MP or testifying during the process. But there are still a few more important steps where we, as creators, need to stay informed and engaged to protect our digital voices and businesses. Because honestly, we're just still not sure where exactly this will land. What I can tell you is that we don't want you to move out of Canada. Seriously, for real, put down that moving app, because here's what's happening next. The Senate is gonna vote in February, then the bill will return to the House of Commons, and the House will decide which amendments they will accept from the Senate. And then there's gonna be a bit of back and forth, and once both the House and the Senate pass an identical version of the bill, it can receive royal assent and become the law, at least in Canada. But again, this can and will have global impact because open platforms facilitate the free exchange of cultural content. And one thing that we've shared in our testimony and our submissions to the government is how Bill C-11 could set a harmful global precedent. And if Canada moves forward without amendments that address the concerns from creators, other countries could follow suit, making it harder for creators to access global audiences. And that absolutely would impact the businesses and livelihoods of millions of entrepreneurial creators in Canada, in the US, and just around the world. So all creators, all of us, should be watching and listening and staying informed on everything that comes next. I'll be back with another update in 2023, and you can follow along on the Canada blog for more, much more. But in the meantime, thank you so much for watching and sharing your voice.